What is up guys, it's Rely here. Today I'm going to be telling you how you can render transparent video in Blender. Alright guys, so this video is actually going to be split up into two parts. The first part I'm going to tell you how to render transparent video in Blender, and the second part I'm going to show you how you can save transparent images in Blender. Alright guys, hope you enjoy and let's get into the video. Alrighty guys, so first of all, let's find out how we can render transparent video in Blender. Alright, so essentially, the first thing you want to do is make certain objects transparent as well as the background. So in this case, as you can see, I have this nice green color, but this green color I actually want to be replaced with the video. And to do this, I'm going to use an alpha channel or transparency. Alright guys, so the first thing we're going to do is actually navigate to the right of your screen and click on render properties. From here, we're actually going to click the film dialog. And then we're going to have some more options that are going to appear. We're actually going to tick this transparent box. So what this is going to do is make the world background, so where the sky would be, it's going to make that transparent. So if I rendered this right now, every single thing here would be transparent except for the like, subscribe, comment, that little motion graphics element, as well as that green box. But as you guys can see, there's a little bit of an issue here because I wanted this green box to actually be included in the transparency. Alrighty, so to actually achieve this, I'm first of all going to select the object that I want to be transparent, so in this case the green box. And the next thing I'm going to do is actually navigate over to the right here, to the material properties section. From here, you'll see that we already have a material selected. If you don't have this, you'll probably need to press new and it will make a new material. And yeah, from there, you'll have a little surface dialog here. You actually need to change the surface type from emission to holdout. I was actually confused with what holdout meant when I first got Blender, but it's really, you don't really need to know the meaning of the name, but essentially what it does is it takes away that section of the screen or that material or that object, and it actually makes that transparent. So I could actually make this little motion graphics rectangle element here. I could make that holdout if I wanted to, and that would make any materials associated with it transparent, which is kind of cool. But yeah, for the purpose of this video, I just want the green box to be transparent. Alrighty guys, so now that I have everything that I want to be transparent, I need to set up the render settings so that we can actually render a transparent video. The reason I have to set up these render settings is actually because some codecs or video formats don't support the alpha channel, and the alpha channel is essentially transparency. So we need to ensure that whatever codec or container we are using, or file format in other words, we need to ensure that that file format actually allows transparency. Alright guys, so navigate over to the right here and select output properties. Alright, from here, you need to scroll down until you see this output section. Then you want to change the file format from PNG to FFmpeg video. Alright guys, now click this encoding dropdown and you'll see a lot more information. Don't let this overload you, it's actually not that complicated. So if you want to render a transparent video in Blender, you just need to change the container from Matroska to Quicktime, and you need to change the video codec from H.264 to QT animation. And if you would also like audio in the final video, you can also select this AAC audio codec, but if you don't want audio, then there's no need to do that. Alright guys, finally, if we scroll up, you'll see that there's this section here where you actually find the folder you want to export your video into. I actually have a video explaining like how to export videos, so I'm not going to go over that in this video, but it's pretty self-explanatory. Just select your directory and it will export a video there. So down here, we actually have a color section. We have RGB, which is selected by default, which means red, green, and blue. And then we have RGBA, which means red, green, blue, and alpha. Now, as I said before, alpha actually stands for transparency. So if you would like to have transparency in your final video, you need to click this RGBA. Alright guys, now everything should be set up perfectly, So as long as you've entered your file location, you can actually go up here, press render, and press render animation. Or you can press Ctrl F12. Alright guys, let's move on to the second half of the video. So let's say that I just wanted to render one frame with transparency, not the entire animation. For example, I like this frame here where it has like, comment, and subscribe very clearly, and it also has that motion graphics element. Well, if we press F12, or we navigate up here to render and click render image, you'll notice that the transparent background is here, but as of right now, this is not saved as a file. So how do we save this one frame as an image to our computer? Well, actually navigate up here to image, press save or save as, and then you can find your file location and save it there. Just a reminder that you need to use a file format that actually supports transparency. One that I like to use is .png. Thank you for watching the video, everyone. I hope that you enjoyed. I hope that it's helped you work out how to actually render transparent video in Blender. If this video did help you, I would really appreciate it if you could like, subscribe, and comment, because that helps my video be seen by more people. Anyway, I hope you guys have a great day. I'll see you next time.